Hey everybody, Tron Crusher here, or because I'm fantastic game flow join happiness. Welcome to the channel. Today we are back with another episode of Radgun series, and in today's video I want to talk about VPO136. As you may know, this gun dominates early game. Everybody runs this gun around like the first couple of weeks or 2-3 weeks of the wipe, but I want to see if this gun is still good budget gun for mid to later in the wipe. So without further ado, let's crush it. Alright, now we are back, let's talk VPO136. First thing first is to show you how to get your hands on this gun. This gun is really available. You can find this gun at level 1 skier for 31,000 rubles, or you can also get it at level 1 skier for 1 sausage, just a trade. Also, you can find it pretty cheap on flea market, around the same like 30,000 rubles, sometimes even cheaper than that. So it's a really available gun. Let's mod this VPO136 together. This gun comes with 55 ergonomics, 98 vertical recoil and 273 horizontal recoil. Let's improve that. First thing we want to change is to change our muzzle from VPO136 to RRD4C muzzle brake. If you don't have access to this one because it comes at mechanic level 4, you also can use the TTAK and use the 545 variant on top of it. But if you have a level 4 mechanic, just use the RRD4C for the 7.62 caliber. Then you want to change your handguard to RS47 handguard. For the foregrip, we are using RVG foregrip. For the flashlight, we are using Balder Pro tactical flashlight. It's pretty good for the price. You want to remove your rear sight and add Bastion dust cover. On top of that, that gives us another recoil reduction. On top of that, we want to you can use any of the sights you want. I'm going to use the SRS-02 here. This sight is growing on me and I'm using it more and more. Any of the 30 rounders, you can use the AK-30 for better ergonomics. And for your pistol grip, use the Tapco sub-pistol grip. And lastly, for your stock, use the Archangel stock. This is how the gun look like. And the stats are 72 ergonomics, 58 vertical recoil, and 161 horizontal recoil. And if you're wondering how much this is gonna cost you, if you go here to find parts, take out the parts that comes with the gun and we don't need it, like the gas tube. As you can see, the mods all together are 98,000 rubles, and if you include the price of the gun on top of it, is 129,000 rubles, so around 130,000 rubles for everything together. Next thing I want to quickly touch on is what kind of ammo and what kind of magazine you should use for this gun. Any of the 30 rounder magazines you want to use, doesn't matter, we have a really high ergo, just go with which one you like. But also you can use the 50 rounder magazine because we have a really high ergo, 74 ergo. If you even slap the 50 rounder magazine, we still have 59 ergo. That's really high ergo, and it's great if you want to use the high capacity mag. You really don't need it because it's a semi-auto gun, but if you want to, there's no penalties basically there. And for the ammo, I say at the minimum use PS. If you can use PP or BP, those are better. But PS has 35 penetration and 57 damage. It's not so relevant now. I would mostly put it at the bottom of the magazine and top load it with PP or BP, but if that's all you have, you can still use the PS. But the best one, the all-rounder, I think the PP is the best round for this gun because we are trying to run it budget. PP is great. You can buy it from Prepper right up, and it has 41 penetration and 55 damage. That means it goes through class 4 basically 90% of the times. And if you have access to BP, you can just top load that because BP is really hard to come by, but BP has 47 penetration and 58 damage, and it's one of the best rounds basically in the game. Lastly, let's rate this gun together. For availability, I give it 9 out of 10. Discon. You can buy it on flea market for cheap. You can buy it from Skier level 1, and also you have a trade for it. So it's the most available gun. That 1 point that I take off on the availability points is because of the RRD4C muzzle and the Archangel stock, basically because those are higher level traders. For versatility, I give it 6 out of 10. It's a semi-auto gun. It's not too good for close quarter and CQB and short range engagements because of the nature of the gun, which is the semi-auto gun. But for medium range, longer ranges, and even sniping, if you want to put a sight on it and do that, it's a great gun because it uses the 7.62 caliber. Cost per performance, I give it 7 out of 10. It's a really cost-effective gun. Uses the 7.62. You can use BP or PP. It's a great gun for around 130,000 rubles. High ergo, decent recoil, everything. It's a well-rounded gun. For effectiveness, I give it 8 out of 10. It uses the 7.62 again. It comes all back to that caliber. It's a really good caliber, and it's a really effective caliber against class 4 and class 5 armor, especially in the mid to late game. And fun factor, I give it 6 out of 10. It is not the most fun gun, but basically the AK platform after AR-15 platform is the most modular platform in this game, and you can build it different ways. Gun feels good, and since we all use this gun so much since the early days of the Tarkov, we are familiar with it and it is fun to use. And that brings our total down to 7.2 out of 10, and we finally have another gun which scores better than ADAR and take that first place of the best budget gun from ADAR. Now ADAR had 6.8 out of 10, and this gun has 7.2. it is a better budget gun than ADAR. Thanks for watching till end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please make sure to like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. We are putting out more budget videos out here for you. Also, I'm thinking about to make some meta builds here shortly. But if you want to stay tuned and see those videos, please make sure to like and subscribe to the channel. That's gonna be a big support for me as well. Also, you can find me on TikTok here if you want to see some of the short format videos. We are working on gunsmiths right now there, the builds, so there's a reference for anybody that wants to go just there and take a look at a 30-40 seconds video and do their task. So that's a help right there. At the end, let me know down in comments, what do you think of the PO136? Do you still use it, or you use under guns because it's a mid to late vibe? And what do you think? Is the ADAR better with the 5.56 or the VPO136 with 7.62? Thanks for watching till end of the video, and I see you guys on the next one.